Hello, 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 car lovers worldwide, and welcome to This Week in Cars. Wow, I thought that was going to sound better. It's a sad week this week. The very last production McLaren P1 has finished its time in Woking in the McLaren factory. Although this specification isn't necessarily the best color scheme that I've seen, the P1 is just one of those cars that you can't help but love. You know, I adored the P1, but I'm really looking forward to what's going to be coming next after this incredible legacy that McLaren has created. With the F1, the P1, now I can't help but wonder, what's next? Will it fall in line with the F1, the P1, or will it top them both? Who knows, I guess we'll just have to see. Either way, I know that I'm going to want one, despite not having nearly enough money. Picture this. Imagine driving through the countryside in a two-seater convertible with your loved one, listening to the music playing and the roar of that 1.5-liter three-cylinder engine working alongside a 7.1 kilowatt-per-hour lithium-ion battery? Doesn't sound right. Not quite what I was expecting. Well, nonetheless, BMW has confirmed the imminent production of the BMW i8 Spider to begin sometime in 2016, and it looks the exact same as the BMW i8 Coupe, except without the roof. Granted that this thing still won't be making a whole lot of noise, you'll be able to have better conversations with your passenger now. Aside from the wind noise.
What did you say? What? I can't hear you! The wind is too loud!
Turn the music down! Turn it down!
However, if you want an i8 that's really going to roar, well, there is one. Gebura Racing Technologies is a German tuning company in Germany. Well, of course it's in Germany. They're a German tuning company that have installed a 4.4-liter V8 from a BMW M6 into the front of a German-registered i8, and have tuned it even further, giving the car a grand total of 800 horsepower. The engine is located under the bonnet of the car rather than behind the driver, and I think it's safe to say that this i8's mileage is going to take a very hard hit now that it has a big gas-guzzling V8 inside of its body. Yeah, this one isn't so much of a story, but I thought it was cool, so deal with it. This car owner not only decided to stick antlers and a red nose onto his car, which happens to be a Lamborghini Huracan, but he also went that extra mile and wrapped some of the parts of the car in a satin black look, which really complements the red. This car would be the ideal gift to Santa. His sleigh broke down and he needed help delivering all the gifts across the world. And it's really nice to see exotic car owners get in the spirit of the holiday season by decorating their cars. If you know of any other exotic cars that are feeling quite festive this holiday season, describe them in the comments below. The time has come once again for Lamborghini to release another limited production vehicle, this time to commemorate what would be the 100th birthday of the company's original founder, Ferruccio Lamborghini. The renders of the Lamborghini Centenario look like it's going to follow in the footsteps, sort of like the path of the Reventon, Veneno, and Sesto Elemento, in terms of the incredible design and performance, as well as the extreme rarity, since only 20 of these are set to be produced. The Centenario is set to make its world debut at the Geneva Motor Show in March, and it is said to feature the same 6.5-liter V12 engine that's in the current Aventador, giving it an estimated whopping 759 brake horsepower. Wow. This model will also be street legal, which makes it a lot more appealing to some of the prospective buyers because they want to be driving on the street as well as on the track, and prices are rumored to begin somewhere around $2 million. Wow. Lastly, to cap off the episode, Evo have released their annual Car of the Year video, which compares some of the best exotic cars from 2015 and determines which of them deserves to be the best. This gathering of cars for an insane group test is not something that you want to miss, because not only are the cars great to look at, but the video is so well made that you'll feel as though you're actually there. Now, I'm not going to ruin the ending for you all, but here's a little tribute to what I think should have won the Car of the Year for 2015. Take a look. Yes guys, that's right, this is a Dodge Neon. I mean, sure it's a 1997 model, and hey, it may not be in the best of shape, but all I need to do is get from destination A to destination B, and this car does a great job in it. I mean, I'm sure would like a P1, but... this car right here, the 1997 Dodge Neon,
deserves to be the 2015 car of the year, in my books at least. All right.
What a great car, huh? Yeah, I know. Don't you want one? Yeah. Well, thank you all for watching another exciting edition of This Week in Cars, and make sure to tune in again next week for another update on news in the car world. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for more. This has been Jake, and drive safe.